Hello and welcome to A-Level Math. This video covers some information from both the quadratic equations and complex numbers. So this video assumes that you have already covered the previous lectures that I have covered in complex numbers. However, any understanding on quadratic equations as of now is not required as I'll be taking it up from scratch. So let's get started. Assume that you are given a quadratic equation like this: ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So this can be any quadratic equation. Say for example, you can have 3x square minus 5x plus 8 is equal to 0, where a is equal to 3, b is equal to minus 5, and c is equal to 8. So if you are familiar with dealing with questions, these types of questions in class 10th, then you might have known a method of solving these by factorizing. But it is not always possible to factorize quadratic expressions. So how to deal with those situations where we are not able to factorize them? So in such cases, we have an explicit formula for finding out the result, or I mean the roots of the quadratic equation, which can be given by this: x is equal to minus b plus minus root over b squared minus 4ac whole inside this root divided by 2a, where a, b and c are given by 3, minus 5 and 8 respectively. So you just put in the values of b, a and c over here and you get the values for your x. You'll be getting two answers. Remember that here we are having the highest power 2, so we can have at most two answers. Similarly, if I give you a cubic equation, you can have at a maximum of three roots of that equation. And similarly, if I give you any power of x, say for example, if I give you an equation with the highest power of x being equal to say 8, then for that equation you can have at most 8 answers. So we will stick to the cases where we are having at most a power of 2, that means quadratic equations. So let's see how we derive this formula. So let's move on. So what we do, I multiply this entire equation by a on both the sides. So I multiply it with a on the left hand side and on the right hand side. Remember that when I multiply with some number on both the sides, then I inherently assume that that number is not equal to 0. So here I have inherently assumed that a is not equal to 0. Okay, so this you have to keep in mind. So even if even in some cases you'll see mentioned that a is not equal to 0, and that is why this multiplication becomes possible, because if a is 0, then you cannot do multiplication. Otherwise you can prove almost anything is in this universe. Say for example, if you start with 3 is equal to 2, you multiply with 0 on both the sides, you get 0 is equal to 0, which is true. So you might be tempted to see that this is also true, but this is never true, right? So that is why multiplication on both the sides with 0 is inadmissible. You're not allowed to do that. Alright, so let's move on. So we have assumed that a is not equal to 0 and hence multiplied by a on both the sides. Now let's see what we get on multiplication. A squared x squared plus abx plus ac is equal to 0. A times 0 is 0. Now what do we do? We make up a perfect square out of this expression. So how do we do that? Let's see. So a squared x squared can be written as ax the whole squared. So we are having something of the form a square, then we need plus 2 into a into b. So this is our a over here. So 2a, and what do we multiply with this expression to get this? So we multiply with a half to cancel these two a twos, and then we are already having ax, we just multiply with a b over here. You see, if you simplify this entire thing, you get this. So that is why this adjustment is required. So this gives us the form 2ab, and then we forcefully bring in the b square part and then subtract it. This is the trick for completing the squares, and then whatever is left out, you just write it. So in this way, we complete a square. So you see, a square x square is here, then this entire thing is abx, all right? And then, so this is 2ab, so we forcefully bring in b square and then subtract it again, and ac remains as it is. So this is how you complete squares. Okay, so now this, let me clean it up. So this entire thing from here to here is a perfect square. You can write it as ax plus half b the whole squared, right? And you can simplify the rest of the two by taking them to the other side. So we take half b whole square minus ac, and you can also simplify this. So we get b square by 4 minus ac. You can simplify it further by taking 4 as LCM. So b square minus 4ac. Alright, so what do? We take this square to the other side. So we will be having ax plus half b is equal to plus or minus, because square it is either plus or minus, so you have to include both. Then root over b square minus 4ac divided by 2, because 4 root is 2. Alright, now you take this half b to the other side. So what you get? Ax is equal to minus half b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac divided by 2, and you can take 2 as an entire LCM. So you'll be getting minus b plus or minus root over b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2, and then you can take this a2 in the denominator. So finally you'll be having x is equal to minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2. This is the formula for calculating the roots of the quadratic equation. So you'll be getting two roots, one by putting the plus sign and another by putting the minus sign. So the two roots are one with a plus sign and another with a minus sign. Remember that this expression inside the root is called the discriminant of the quadratic equation. B square minus 4ac is the discriminant. Okay, let's take up some examples now. We have to solve this quadratic equation. So let's quickly write down, first of all, the coefficients. What do a, b and c stand for here? So a is 3 over here, which is clearly not equal to 0. B is 8i and c is equal to minus 3. Alright, so let's quickly write down the formula. X is equal to minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. Let's put down these values. So b is equal to 8i, so it's minus 8i plus minus root over 8i the whole squared minus 4 times what is a? 3 times what is c? C is it's plus 3, it's not minus 3, so c is also 3 whole divided by 2 into a, which is 3, is equal to minus 8i plus minus root over 8i the whole squared is 64i square minus 4 threes are 12, 12 threes are 36 whole divided by 3 twos are 6 is equal to minus 8i plus or minus root over. So you see, minus 36 can be written as 36i square, right? So 64i square plus 36i square, because we know that I square is equal to minus 1. So remember that you have already understood the previous lectures of complex numbers. So that is how we adjust the negative sign over there by replacing it I square and whole divided by 6. And further simplification gives us x is equal to minus 8i plus minus root over 64i squared plus 36i squared is 100i squared whole divided by 6. Then minus 8i plus or minus root over 100i squared is 10i whole divided by 6. And then when we take the plus sign, that means when we take this plus, So we get the first value of x to be minus 8i plus 10i divided by 6, and another value as minus 8i minus 10i whole divided by 6. So that means we get 2i divided by 6, which is I by 3, and another value as minus 18 upon 6, which is minus 3i. So these are the two values that we get. Hope that makes sense to you. Let's take up some new topic wherein we need to find out the square root of a complex number. So there are two methods to find out the square root of any complex number. The first method is a long way. That means there are a lot of things that you need to do. Of course, it is a long way, but it also has some advantages. I'll tell you that when I explain the method to you. And another one is a shortcut. Even though it's a shortcut, it takes a lot of foresightedness. You have to see all the adjustments, and you have to be, there are certain tricks that you have to be familiar with. So I'll first take up the long method. So the advantage of long method is that you don't have to strain your brain too much. It's a straightforward method. You have to do some important steps, without any changes in the step. The steps are more or less almost the same in every example, in every such question. So that is the advantage of the long method. It's always you have to follow the same lines solution. So let's approach that way. So we have to find out the square root of 6 plus 8i. That means we have to find out the square root, which is this. This you have to evaluate. Okay, so let's assume that it is something of the form x plus iy. Of course, the reason behind this assumption is that a square root of a complex number is, I think, will be a complex number, don't you think, as well? So let us assume whatever be the square root of this complex number, whatever it be, let us assume that it is of the form x plus iy. Then all our task is to find out the values of this x and y, and that's it. So how do we approach for it? We just square both the sides first. So what we have, 6 plus 8i on the left hand side, and on the right hand side we have x plus iy the whole squared, which is x squared plus I squared y squared plus 2xyi. Alright, so this I square can be written as minus 1. So we have 6 plus 8i is equal to x squared minus y squared plus 2xyi. So what do we get? We get that equating the real and imaginary parts, you remember we discussed in the previous video that this is the real part of the complex number and so is this. So they have to be equal. So x squared minus y squared is equal to 6, and these are the two imaginary parts of the complex number, so they have to be equal as well. So we get 2xy is equal to 8. So this is called as equating the real and the imaginary parts. Alright, now we have two equations in two variables, x and y, and all we need to do is to solve them. So it might be difficult for you to solve them, so let me show you how to approach it. So we have 2xy is equal to 8, so from here we get xy is equal to 4. So you find out one in terms of the other, so you can find out y as in terms of x. So we get y is equal to 4 by x, and then what you do, you just put down the value of y over here. So what do you get? X squared minus, what is y squared, is 4 by x the whole squared is equal to 6. Okay, but this may lead you into serious trouble, so we'll have some another trick for it. So you may go with this method as well. The problem here is that you will be getting something in the terms of x to the power of 4, and that will make you go crazy. Okay, so there is a simple trick that you can use over here, and the trick is that you have to use this formula. Which formula? Let me write it down over here. There is a formula which says that a plus b the whole squared is equal to a minus b the whole squared plus 4ab. So this is the formula that you can use. A plus b the whole squared is equal to a minus b the whole squared plus 4ab. So think that you are having a as x squared and b as y squared. So that means if you want to find out the value of x squared plus y squared, think of a as x squared and b as y squared, then you can write it down as x squared minus y squared the whole squared plus 4 x squared y squared, just replacing a and b with x squared and y squared. Sorry, I'm missing out a whole square over here. X squared plus y squared the whole squared. A in place of a you write down x squared, in place of b you write down y squared. Okay, so we have these values. X squared minus y squared is 6, so we get 6 squared plus 4 x squared y squared is 2 xy the whole squared, which is also known to us. So we get 36 plus 2 xy is equal to 8, so we get 8 squared, which is equal to 36 plus 64, which is equal to 100. So we get x squared plus y squared the whole squared is equal to 100. So that means x squared plus y squared is equal to plus minus root over 100, which is 10. But minus 10 is not possible over here because x and y are both real numbers. Remember, for any complex number, so x and y are always real. This is the I that is making this part complex, but x and y are always real. So like 6 plus 8i or 3 plus 5 or anything, 6, 8, 3, 5 are all real numbers. So x and y are real numbers, so their squares can never be negative. So if you add two non-negative numbers, I repeat, x and y are real numbers, so their squares can never be negative. They are either 0 or positive. So if you add those two numbers, something 0 or positive, you can never get minus 10 because they are either 0 or positive. There can be no situation where they are negative. So that is why minus 10 is not possible over here. So x squared plus y squared is definitely plus 10. And then we are having two equations which can give us the result straight away. First is x squared minus y squared is equal to 6. Another is x squared plus y squared is equal to 10. Now you just add these two and see what you get. So you get 2x squared is equal to 16. That gives you x squared is equal to 8. That gives you x is equal to plus or minus root 8, which is plus or minus 2 root 2. Alright, so root 8 can be written as 4 into 2. Root over 4 into 2. Root 4 is 2, so you can take this 2 outside. And then root 2 is what remains. So x is equal to 2 root 2. And similarly, if you subtract these two equations, these two equations, if you subtract, then you'll be getting 2y squared is equal to 10 minus 6, which is 4, which gives you y square is equal to 2, which gives you y is equal to plus or minus root 2. Okay, so you're getting x as plus or minus 2 root 2, y as plus or minus root 2. So what are the possibilities? First possibility is that x is 2 root 2 and y is root 2. That is possible. And another possibility is you take both of the negative signs, minus 2 root 2 and minus root 2. So you take x as minus 2 root 2 and y as minus root 2. But the other possibility, that means taking x as positive and y as negative, is not possible because 2xy has to be 8 at the same time. So suppose if you take x positive and y negative, then the entire result is negative, but that is not possible. 8 is something positive, right? So that is why all the four combinations are not possible. Only these two combinations are possible. Either you take both positive, x positive and y positive, or you take both negative, x negative and y also negative. You cannot take one positive and the other negative, because we also have to make sure that this happens. So that is why we are getting these two answers only. So one answer is x is equal to 2 root 2 and y is root 2. Another one is x is equal to minus 2 root 2 and y is equal to minus root 2. So our two answers, the two square roots are 2 root 2, x is 2 root 2, so 2 root 2 plus root 2i, and another one is minus 2 root 2 minus root 2i. So these are the two square roots and we are done. Let's take up one more question, but this time I'll show you how to do this with a shortcut method. So the shortcut method is very small, but you have to think a lot for it. So what you do, the idea here is that think of this 12i as something of the form 2ab. So the reason why we think of this as 2ab is that, you see, initially as well we got as our 2xy is equal to 8. So that 8i was the part that was giving us the 2ab. So you think of this 12 as something of the form 2ab, and this minus 5 has to be thought of as a square minus b square, and that is also we get from the previous thing. So these are actually the tricks that can help you solve the answer. So x squared minus y squared was 6, right? So this you have to think of x squared minus y squared, and 8 is something of the form 2xy. So the trick here is that you have to write down your question like this: minus 5 plus 12y, you have to write it as minus 5 plus 2 into ab, whatever is left out. So that means here 6i is left out. Always separate this 2, because we have to write it in the form 2ab. Okay, we need to make up a complete whole square out of this. The idea here is that I will convert this entire thing into a whole square. So for a whole square, I need three terms. I need a square plus b square or minus b square, whatever. A square plus or minus b square, and then I need a 2ab. So the first task is to get the 2ab. So you separate the 2 out of it and leave whatever is left out. And now this minus 5, always adjust it as a square minus b square, never plus. It's always a square minus b square. Always try to find out a and b such that a square minus b square gives you minus 5. Okay, so let me erase all these things and summarize whatever I said to you. So the first thing you have to do is write this 12 as 2ab. So 2 is left out. This is something of the form ab. So you have to think of a and b such that when you multiply them, you get 6i. And also that you get a square minus b square is equal to minus 5. So can you think of some a and b such that when you multiply them, you get 6i, and also a square minus b square gives you minus 5. So say for example, if I take one possibility, I take a is equal to 2 and I take b is equal to 3i. So if I multiply these two, 2 and 3i, I get 6i. That's okay, that's not a difficult one. But to verify whether I'm getting a square minus b square as minus 5 or not, that's the biggest task. So what is a square? A square minus b square is 4 minus 3i, the whole squared gives you 4, minus 9i square, that gives you 4, plus 9, which gives you actually 13. So we're not getting minus 5 over here. So then what to do? I'm sorry. We always need this to be a square plus b square to be equal to minus 5. So a square plus b square, how much it turns out? A square minus b square turns out to be 4 plus I square is minus 1. So it gives you minus 9. So 4 minus 9 is minus 5. Okay, we are done. So similarly, you have to keep on checking. You have to take a and b such that a and b gives you this ab, and a square minus b square gives you a square plus b square should give you this thing. So in here we are getting this, and what values did we take for a and b? We take 2 and 3i. So that means I can write this as a square 2 square plus b square plus 2 into a into b. So check that I'm getting this same thing or not. 2 square plus 3i square gives you minus 5. We have already checked in here. 2 square is 4 plus 3i square gives you 9i square, and simplification gives you minus 5. So it's giving you minus 5, and this part is giving you 12i. So 2 times 2, 4 times 3 gives you i, right? No problem with that. So I can write it as 2 plus 3i the whole squared. So we have successfully converted this expression into a perfect square. I told you that's the logic behind the shortcut. So you can only apply this shortcut when these finding out these a and b are extremely simple for you. Like in this case, it was too simple, but in all cases it might not be simple. It may involve roots, just like in the previous question. It's the final answer was 2 root 2 and root 2, so it's hard to get hold of those numbers sometimes, but for simple cases you can do it. So our square root of this will be just plus or minus of this. So the square root of minus 5 plus 12i is plus or minus 2 plus 3i, because square root and square gets cancelled out, and you always have a answer in both plus or minus, because square root can be both plus or minus. Just like x square is equal to 9 gives you x as plus or minus 3, similarly plus or minus have to be supplied in any case. So this is the shortcut, and if you want, you can also go with the long method over here. So what you have to do, you start with root over minus 5 plus 12i is equal to x plus iy, square both the sides, you'll be getting x square minus y square is equal to minus 5, and 2xy is equal to 12. Okay, so remember the shortcut. For the shortcut, you need such a and b, such that av gives you 6i, and a square plus b square, I'm sorry for the mistake, a square plus b square gives you this first term. If you're getting such a and b, then your answer is this simple. Just put down the value of a and b, put a plus or minus, and that's it. Okay, so one more question. We have to simplify this. So you see, both of these expressions are almost the same except for this plus over here and this minus over here. So let's start with the first expression. So the first expression is root over 4 plus 3 root over minus 20. Okay, so what is root over minus 20? Root over minus 20 can be written as root 20i, and root 20 can be written as root over 5 into 4i. Root 4 can be written as 2, so we take 2 outside, so it is 2 root 5i. So this can be written instead of minus 20, root over minus 20. So we get our question to be root over 4 plus 3 times 2 root 5i, which gives us root over 4 plus 6 root 5i. Okay, so let's find out the square root of this. First, let's try out the shortcut. If we are not able to get hold of such a and b, then we will go for the longhand method. So what we need, first of all, we write down this entire thing as, so we write it down as 4 plus 2 into, and then whatever is left out, you write that 3 root 5i. So our task here is to get hold of such a and b, such that ab is equal to 3 root 5i, and a square plus b square is equal to 4. Okay, so let's try to find out such a and b. So if you take a as 3 and b as root 5i, what do we get? So if you take a as 3 and b as root 5i, then it gives you ab as 3 root 5i, that's for sure, there is no problem. What is a square plus b square? A square plus b square is 9 plus 5i square. Hey, we are done. 9 minus 5 gives us 4. So we can take a as 3 and b as root 5i. So this can be written as root over a square plus root 5i the whole squared plus 2 into a into b. Okay, so we can write it down as like this, and then we can write it down as 3 plus root 5i the whole squared. So the square root is either plus or minus 3 plus root 5i. Okay, so now similarly, we have another expression, 4 minus of this. So root over 4 minus, it will evaluate to the same 6 root 5i, which I can write it as 2 into 3 root 5i, and the same values of a and b will work over here. So this time, instead of getting a plus b whole square, we'll be getting a minus b whole square, because it'll be a square plus root 5i the whole squared minus 2 into a into b. So we are having a square plus b square minus 2ab, which gives us a minus b the whole squared, 3 minus root 5i the whole squared, and then the square root is either plus or minus 3 minus root 5i. So we have to just find out what do we get on adding these two things. So first expression is this, and the second expression simplifies to this, and we have to find out the sum of these two. So what you do, you first take both positive. So if you take both positive, let me erase the right hand side parts. Okay, so if you take both positive, then what is the expression simplifies to? If you take both positive, that means 3 plus root 5i here and 3 minus root 5i over here, both positive, gives you 3 plus root 5i plus 3 minus root 5i. This root 5i gets cancelled out, so you get 6 when you take both positive. What if you take both negative? So that means minus 3 plus root 5i in the first case for this, and if you take negative over here, you get minus 3 minus root 5i. So again, plus root 5 minus root 5i cancels out, so the answer is minus 6. And what if you take one positive and the other negative? So far we have got two answers. And what if you take one positive? That means let's take positive over here and negative over here. So positive 3 minus root 5i gives you, okay, and then negative minus 3 minus root 5i. So 3 and minus 3 gets cancelled out and you get minus 2 root 5i. And similarly, if you take negative over here and positive over here, you get a plus 2 root 5i. So the four answers that you get are plus 6, minus 6, plus 2 root 5i and minus 2 root 5i. Okay, that's it for this video. All we had to cover is just finding out the square roots of some complex numbers, and we just gave you a brief overlook of quadratic equations and how to solve them and find out a beautiful expression to solve quadratic equations in terms of A, B and C. That's it. Thanks a lot. Study hard and study smart with A-level math. Keep watching. Bye-bye.